We're really entering the place where you're going to have every possible metric you would want, whether it's talking about cost for services and integrating that cost with outcomes. Specialties like dermatology that typically have been outside the larger practice of medicine are starting to get a little bit more integrated in terms of taking care of that whole patient.
Wisdom spot, nothing bad. Spot,
yeah. Here's a specialty where you get a little bit of everything. You get a chance to take care of somewhat straightforward things like warts and acne, but you really have this other great part, which is a great kind of diagnostic and complexity of management piece of dermatology. There's a great prevention side where we get to educate patients to make sure that they can reduce their risk of skin cancer. We're helping them develop the skill sets they need to detect their own skin cancers outside of just our regular scheduled visits.
Take about 5 millimeters around it.
When you talk about early detection of things like cancer, we're on the front line. Solid organ transplant patients are a very unique population. Because of the medicines that they're put on to prevent rejection of the organs that they've received, the rate at which they develop skin cancers is way, way higher than it would be for an average patient. Kind of goal and vision for developing a dedicated dermatology clinic that only sees patients who have undergone transplantation was to fix this problem. One of the things that's really critical is very, very tight communication between the transplant surgeons, the transplant physicians, and the dermatology team. Not just focusing on, let's just keep cutting out skin cancers. No, let's look at how we can optimize the rate at which they get skin cancers to reduce it, but also make sure that they're not going to risk rejecting that organ. And I think that's a very small example of kind of the coordination that's happening in bigger ways, and having resources like a really robust electronic medical record allows for that communication to be structured. When you have kind of pools of data from a bunch of different sources, right, not just dermatology, but looking at kind of the bigger picture of that patient's entire medical record, and not only one patient, but every patient in an entire healthcare system like USF, you're going to find trends that you would otherwise never even realize were there. And by having that kind of giant aggregate pool of data with kind of the integrated medical record with Tampa General, we are giving our researchers a really great set of data that they can mine in whatever way would be relevant for the question that they're trying to answer. The beauty of it is by creating that infrastructure for people, everybody who's an expert in a particular area can look at it from their lens, and we can put all those different kind of analyses together and really change how we're doing things.